Hello Internet! Nicolas Cage is the nephew of director Francis Ford Coppola. But did you know that he once discussed to play Superman? Even if this didn't happen till now, he named his son Kal-El, the birth name of Superman. Well, this name of course is copyrighted since the 1940s, but this is no problem for America. But in Sweden, you can name your kid Superman, Metallica, or this. Even if it seems like my cat walked over the keyboard, this particular name is an appeal of a couple from Sweden who were fined for naming their kid Albin. They issued this pronunciation of Albin to the courts and of course they lost, and then appealed again with the letter A, and they again lost. Sweden, apart from fish and Vikings, is also known for its strict naming law. In the US, parents have a lot of leeway when it comes to naming their children, but this freedom has led to the Campbell case. And I'm not referring to the British newspaper editor, but Heath Campbell, who is known as Heath Hitler. He and his wife Deborah are self-proclaimed Nazis and have named their children, all four of them, after Nazi figures. This case attracted attention first time in 2008, when the couple ordered a birthday cake for their son. The baker declined making a birthday cake reading "Happy Birthday Adolf Hitler," and since then, Heath Hitler has been prosecuted for a variety of reasons. Eventually, he got all his children taken away by New Jersey's Division of Youth and Family Services and put into foster care. Though it was not the reason for being a proclaimed Nazi or naming their children after Nazi figures, but due to domestic violence. Violence is an actual name in New Zealand after a couple decided to name their kid as such. Another couple named their kid Number 16 Bus Shelter. And another one who had twins named their kids after famous tobacco brand Benson and Hedges. After those name shenanigans, the New Zealand authorities had to inspect whether a name is acceptable or not. And by saying acceptable, they mean that the names must not cause offense to a reasonable person, not be unreasonably long, should not resemble a rank or an official title, and of course, no punctuation marks. Some parents really seem to seek the boundaries of what's acceptable and what is not. Since 2001, names like Justice and King have been rejected many times, as well as some other names like Mafia No Fear, Sex Fruit, and For Real. For Real. Some parents even try to sneak inside the actual name, the asterisk sign, or even the period sign, without success though. But strangely enough, parents keep trying. But what if a couple decides to do as they wish, regardless of what the authorities say? Well, the penalty is quite harsh. It doesn't include any fines nor imprisonment. But in 2009, a 9-year-old girl was taken away from her parents so that her name would change from Tallulah Dazehula from Hawaii. You can find a complete list of rejected names by the New Zealand authorities down in the video description. All those weird cases were the reason behind specific names prohibition. Some countries across the world hold an official list of illegal names. This can be either for nobility reasons, like in New Zealand, France, and Switzerland, where you can't name your kid Prince, for example. Terrorist names, like Osama bin Laden, is prohibited as a name in Turkey, Germany, and Sweden. In Saudi Arabia, the name Linda is prohibited as it is associated with Western culture. Japanese name Takuma is a common one, but Akuma stirred such a frenzy in the early 1990s that it is labeled as an illegal name from the Prime Minister's office. What's wrong with this name though is that Akuma means devil in Japanese. Short names can be easily remembered, like Bob or Tim, but there are some cases of people having really long names. Some of them are quite famous though, like Salvador Dali, whose full name is Salvador Domingo Felipe Jacinto Dali y Domenic, having surnames from both his parents following a Spanish tradition. The son of actor Ronald Sutherland, or even Pablo Picasso. But the record for the longest name ever goes to a man born in 1904 whose name was 746 letters long. You can listen to Og Vorbis, who pronounces the whole name on Wikipedia.
Adolf, Blaine, Charles, David, Earl, Frederick, Gerald, Hubert, Irvin, John, Kenneth, Lloyd, Martin, Nero, Oliver, Paul, Quincy.
You get the idea. If you want to listen to the whole name though, you can follow the link on the top right corner of your screen or down in the video description. In the ancient times, though, it was quite common for people to use only one name to be mononymous, like Pluto and Socrates. This was because back then people were far less than today and the need for a surname was not really there. They could be referred, though, as their name plus son of whoever. To this day, there are some people who are legally mononymous, and you can check this list down in the video description. Names can be significant for people regardless of their fame. This is what the name letter effect claims. It's a tendency of people to prefer the letters of the alphabet that feature their name. You can try that yourself. Write down your name and think of places you like, or the first name of your friends' names, or even words you frequently use, or even the music you like. The name itself and its meaning can affect a person's character, personality, and self-esteem levels. Well, if your name is Winner, like the sixth son of the Lame family, then you're in a good position. Imagine this couple having their kid named Loser. Well, funny enough, they did. The Lanes named their seventh and last child Loser. But on the contrary of what studies show, he did succeed after graduating on a scholarship from college, joining the NYPD. To his friends, he is known as Lou. So even if your parents gave you a name you don't like, you can always have a nickname. People are known to have nicknames since 1303. And by nickname, I'm not referring to the word nick. Ick in medieval English was the word for the additional, something extra. So an additional name was an ick name. And because words travel as a sound rather than as a written word, a nickname became gradually one word, and then a nickname became a nickname